Hello everyone, welcome to the session on on-demand video streaming in AWS using AWS Elemental Media Convert. I am Gargi Bhatnagar, I am a certified solution architect and DevOps engineer with 7 years of work experience responsible for creating architecture, implementing high reliable, secure, efficient and cost-effective solutions within an organization. I am a part of AWS Community Builder and publishing various blogs, hosting events and conducting webinars. Let's quickly move on to the session. So in terms of how I have structured the session, I will give the detail on what is meant by streaming a video, what media services which used to stream the video in AWS. And in terms of live streaming, then we'll let you know all about challenges faced during transcoding and delivering of video today. Then in last, we'll be talking about Media Convert, which is fully defined by name as AWS Elemental Media Convert. Also, let you know about what file-based transcoding is and how it is relevant to Media Convert. Then we'll check out some of the key use cases, and hopefully I have some time to pull up the console to do a quick demo job for all of you. First, what is meant by streaming? Basically, streaming is the continuous transmission of audio or video files from servers to client. Streaming makes the audio or video, or we can say a media file, for being played on the client device, whether it's a phone, PC, laptop or TV or any other such devices. If we download a video or audio, then the time taken in downloading process is more than checking out the video or audio in a real time as a streaming. And as per cost perspective, streaming is cheaper in cost in comparison with downloading a media files. So many applications are available which uses streaming for their videos and will support video on demand and live event streaming as well. Applications such as Netflix, Amazon Prime Video, Twitch, Disney Plus Hotstar, YouTube and so on. In such applications, depending on the viewer's demand of video, so the content of the video will be streamed and the viewer can view it in a fraction of seconds without any delay. A viewer can also download it without continuous view of video. There is also no delay while viewing live streaming video content. For video streaming, AWS Media Service is available, which gives video providers an uncompromising set of features at critical stage of the video workflow. It basically represents the core feature in terms of flexibility and easy to use workflow. It includes live video transport, file-based transcoding, live video encoding, origin and packaging, and media storage delivered at broadcast grade services. Before proceeding to Media Convert, first need to know about what is file-based transcoding is. So most of us know and may be aware of transcoding, but essentially want to draw the distinguish between this and live streaming. So file-based transcoding is really you have a source content in the form of files. Now this content could be shot in studio environment or could be shoot on a cell phone or anywhere else. And you really want to process this content because that's the only way you get into different versions that will play back on the range of devices. And part of this processing, you might change of codec, you might change of resolution, or you might change frame rate. And it's a premium content. You might want to apply encryption, DRM, because want a sort of control access rights to the piece of content. Unlike live streaming, a real stream constraint where you need to process video, file-based transcoding can go fast or slow as per underlying hardware, which allows and you have control over quality settings, codec settings and resolution and things on it. Lot of customers uses on-premises solutions. What challenges is that? And looks at cloud-based solutions, what are the challenges? So looking into cloud-based solutions, while lot of this have improved the scalability, So not to worry about buying a infra and setting it up and all of that. Lot of these solutions basically don't provide the feature and capability that need for broadcast grade workflow. And what I mean for broadcast grade workflow is support for formats like SDCAM, for example, HDR capability, or caption support, DRM, for example. So a lot of provider provides this range of capability, but not in one pace. While in case of scalability, we have certain limitations as backup, turnaround time, and sort of delivering high quality experience to customers. And a lot of solutions is suffered from fail in limitation or something goes wrong. And in case of video, it is really important for continuous content in video processing workflow, mean for lost revenue essentially. Lot of these suffered from complicated pricing, as known that estimates calculated before of heavy workloads implementation. It makes it harder and difficult for customers. You can't really commit on pricing and many onboarding issues as well. It is not really easy to build end-to-end workflows, setting up the infra and managing. It is really difficult and not really easy in flexible manner. So introducing about AWS Elemental Media Convert. Now switch into Media Convert. Our goal is Media Convert is really made very easy to build broadcast grade workflows in the cloud. In that, customer having an access to professional grade video features and quality. So the same kind of capabilities that the Elemental server have offered over the years in services. No need to manage software and hardware infra. So combining on-premises and cloud solution. So getting access to a full range of capabilities and getting access to not manage of any infra. The service automatically scales in response to variations in incoming video volumes. So as customers of the service, you don't really need to worry about suddenly having a spike, and Media Convert is responsible for sort of identifying that and figuring out scale ups and add new instance to go and handle that spike in video volume. And finally, ability to manage capacity, how customers wanted build workflow and priority of job, or we can control over job execution order number. So let's look at the key components of Media Convert. So the key thing is primary unit of work is a job. Job is basically made up of input or more outputs and the bunch of settings that define what the output needs to be created. Job can also have metadata. Metadata basically a key pair value that you define and sort of preserve with the job. For if you want to enable tracking or in case intelligence, so now all of these settings that define a particular output, so there is like codec, bitrate, resolutions and things. So you can set them as preset. Each preset basically gives an output, one output, and together combinedly called as output group. Now you can imagine that for one job, you are creating more one output. So basically, you get more hardware, different format videos. We can create it as per our requirement and save as a job template. And we can use this templates again and again for different inputs. Job templates saves input configuration and can be reused. And the job needs to be submitted to queues. And it manages the job as per priority basis. So here resources means the number of job you can process in parallel at a given point in time. So every job needed to be submitted to queue, and by default every account have access to about 40 job slots which can be used to process jobs in parallel. Let's say for example you have submitted 100 jobs to the queue. That 40 remaining of those start processing immediately, and remaining 60 wait in the queue managed by Media Convert. and stay in the queue as long as one of the slots does not open up. Once 40 gets done, next 60 job will be in process. So next coming jobs will be scheduled or will wait in a queue. So in this use case where you have higher versus lower priority jobs, so if you have to process a job after a month and a job you need to run urgently, so you want high priority jobs run first. So you can create additional queue in account, and what queue does is splits the resources of availability in the account. It essentially creates a reserve lane, runs 20 jobs in parallel so that 20 slots will be free for priority jobs. S output created will be placed in S3. So when submitting a job, it goes to a job state, then processing a state that either it completes successfully or fails. Each change in state is the media convert publish an event to the cloud watch and notified via email or SMS as per configure of the SNS service for complete or error state of the job. Event happens can be automated using Lambda, means to a serverless platform. So basically the media convert pricing based on the that it does not have a minimum fees, don't have to pay as you go model, and the rate based on the duration of the output video, and you have to pay what the services only you are using. Some of the use case of it, such as event happening in university for online education, in news channel and sports. Media Convert is being used in many social platform as already defined as Prime Video, Netflix and Hotstar, and many enterprises even using it for video streaming. Even I have configured the service in some of the client side, around 8 to 9 clients, and they are successfully using it at low cost with high resolution videos. Some of the Media Convert benefits, scalability and performance in business. And in many organizations, there is a reduction in risk featured for broadcast workflows in the cloud. Let's quickly get in demo. The architectural flow for the current Hanson Lab use case. So there are two buckets, source bucket and a destination bucket. So whenever there's an input of the file in the source bucket, the S3 triggers and it goes to the Lambda function. So the Lambda consists of a convert.py file, which triggers the media convert service, which has the preset settings already set. As per that, it will convert the files to the and stores in the destination bucket. Now, whenever there is an activity happens in the media convert, it generates an event that is the event based in the event bridge, and there is a media convert which tells that it's a complete or it's an error activity. So it will send the notification to the admin or user through SNS service. Let's go to the console and have some quick hands-on lab. So in S3 console, you can see here two buckets. That is, one is for input folder bucket and other is output folder bucket. So in input folder bucket, I'm going to input. I've created one more subfolder, that is input. In this, I can input my number of video files which I want to convert into some other formats, and that files will be converted and stored in the output folder bucket. So I have created one IAM role, that is a media convert role. This role basically have a policy of Amazon S3 full access and API gateway invoke full access. Another role I have created, that is a VOD Lambda role. So basically this roles have two permissions, that is AWS Lambda basic execution role and VOD Lambda policy. So this role is to be assigned on the Lambda function. Next I have created a function, Lambda function. So it's basically a video Lambda convert function that I've created on Python 3.8. The handler which I have given is a convert.handler. So in this function, I have imported and created a convert.py function, that is basically a Python function which can take my source bucket video and convert into the destination and save into the destination bucket as per the requirements and as per the presets I have already given in the pipeline. So these are the output groups, output settings which I can define and give it in the pipeline. Again, I've created a job.json function. So this function specifies that what is the custom name, what is the HLS, and in which format I need to convert, what are the specific parameters I need to convert, and what is the width, what is the height of the video, and different other parameters includes in this JSON file. So you can see over here that there are some container settings, there are some video descriptions, and here I can see that what is the bit rate and what is the frame control. So I can able to customize my setting as per the requirement and as per the cost, plus as per the in terms of security perspective, I can also do that here. So you can see here codec settings. And if I can go to the downwards, like this is a video description of another one. So a number of parameters I have given over here as per the requirement. Then I have also set here a S3 trigger on the bucket. So I've done this because whenever any kind of video I can input in this my input folder. So that should be converted into the and saved into the destination folder. And this to be done automatically. So this task has to be done automatically. I have given here event type as object created and the prefix I have set as inputs. As you have already told that I have created a subfolder named as input. So the same name I have given here as a prefix. Okay. So if you can input any kind of folder output outside this input folder, then there will be a problem because it only counts the prefix which is and the videos which are there in the inside the input folder. Then in the SNS, I have created a notification service. So basically, I've created a topic and I've created a subscription over it on my mail ID. And this I've done because whenever any kind of activity happens on my job, so I can get a notification on the mail. So I don't want to go into the console again and again and check it everything, like my pipeline is failed or my pipeline is completed and everything. So next, I've converted. So for this purpose, I've created a rule, that is a VOD notify event rule. Basically, this rule is just giving a notification activity purpose, and this give notification to the mail. And I have given a target over here as an input transformer. This goes to for my target as SNS topic, and you can see here input transformer. So I have given here the various details, like this is the thing and this is the job which is run or finished and everything. So in Media Convert, I don't want to have to create any kind of job over here. So just I'll give a quick demo. I'll give I upload a folder. So you can go to the edit files. I have already one. So this is my testing and I upload this testing video over here. So you can just go and upload. So once the file gets uploaded, I can see that the job starts with the same name of the file over Media Convert, and it starts converting to number of custom presets what I have set in the HLS format and the MP4 format. So it's get done. So just go to the Media Convert and just refresh the page, and you can get that like you testing is .mp4 and it's in progressing state. So just go to the job ID. You can able to see various things over here, like what is the current retry count and what how much job percent completed and what is the current duration in the queue and submitted time and finishes time and everything. And this is the console of Media Convert where I can input the file and I can get the output as HLS format, file group MP4 format, some thumbnails as well. So this is the thing. So just refresh it and you can see the number of percent as well. Like just go back and just refresh again and again. so still is in a process progressing state. So we'll just wait for something. Yeah, so it's get completed, and again you can go inside and check that this is the transcode duration. This is the transcode in duration in queue, and the finishes time and date as well over here, and what kind of role has been applied on it and everything, right? So these are the output formats which I can get. Again, you can go to the output folder, just close it and go to the output folder in the output bucket. So this is my output bucket, and we can see that this is the testing which I have already given in the starting video file. So this go to that. So this is we can see HLS format, MP4 format, thumbnail. So just go to HLS and just one more thing over here, that the total size of the file which we can give as an upload will give we can get a different number of files, the smaller size than that, and as well as in the number of chunks. So you can just go and check out any kind of file, like just click on this and download. Also you can give a TS file as well and just download, so you can just go and play it. So it's not supportive, so just go and open with some other, you know, type. So this is only applicable for a VLC player. So just go and show in folder. So this is the file, it's already completed testing. Just open with other application. Yeah. So you can see this is my file. You can see here what kind of clarity of the video is, and also the size also gets reduced because there are number of TS files and it is distributed in a chunk. Okay. Then you can go back to some other format and you can check that as well. So you can go to testing again and in MP4. So the file is also converted to MP4. You can see that this is 68.0 MB file, and you have given your input as so this is my input file, and so my testing file is 95.8 MB. So size is also reduced and the quality is also increased as per in the performance as well. So again, go back to the output folder and just go to the testing, and I can go to the MP4 format and just download it again. Right. So once the file gets downloaded, I'll show you the total quality of the file as well. So just go in the show folder. So this is my MP4 file which is currently downloaded. Just open it. So you can see here. So this is my MP test file which I have currently downloaded. You can see the time as well, 1836. So this is the testing.mp4 file, and you can see the full file has been downloaded with less number of KB, and you can see the quality of the file. And in terms of costing as well, it's like half of the current on which we are doing all the things manually. So instead of doing things manually, you can make the process automate and also give the less price in it. So similarly, if I can input one more file, I'll go to the input folder in inputs and just upload a file. So basically here just you can see that I can able to do a file conversion of sample space file name, space is counted, then without space, and if I'll write continue and what will happen, right? So I'll just add one more file. So I have a file video hyphen, so I'm using a symbol in the between of the files. What will happen, we can see over here. So I'll just add a file and upload it. So once the file converts, we can see a job running over here. So just go to here and just go to job section and just refresh it. We can see one more file process gets start. Once the, yeah, so we can see over here, this is the video-playback.mp4. Now let's check that whether this process gives an error or it completed with the time. So just refresh the button again and again. You can see the process. So you can see the time duration as well. Okay. You know, some of the files on which we can see the time job percent complete as well, but it's not currently coming over here, but because the file is it's taking duration, so but you can get everything over here. So just refresh it once again. So currently it's in refresh process. One more thing I'll show you till that. Just go to CloudWatch console again. Just go to log section in the log group. You can see a log which is automatically comes over here via whenever a Lambda runs. So you can get the status of all the jobs running. So currently we have done a jobs. Just go to this and you can check out all the logs, like what kind of output groups has been run, what in what format it has been done. So all the logs of the activity can be seen over here, right? So what is the warning and what are the error, everything you can see. So the logs also can be able to trace from CloudWatch log events. Just go back to Media Convert and refresh the page. So you can see the status is completed. That means we have a converted file in the output bucket. So just go to the bucket and check the format. Yeah. So yes, so it is possible to give a video hyphen playback, and it's possible to give a hyphen between this. So there is no problem. We get all the HLS, MP4 and thumbnail as per the custom preset we have set. And just go to MP4 and again you can download it and run the content. So it gets downloaded in some seconds. So this is the overall architectural flow which I have implemented using Media Convert. This Media Convert is a part of a media service and which can easily able to convert a video file in a fraction of seconds, and it's very easy, and as we have made it automated using Lambda function, so it's very easy. We don't need to come again and again on the console and check the things. And you can get in the folder. Just go to the folder and it's completed. Okay, so this is my video of MP4 file. You can check out the time as well, 6:41. So open it with, you can select it.
कहते हैं कि रिस्क न लेना ही इस दुनिया की सबसे बड़ी रिस्क है, क्योंकि रिस्क न लेने वाले लोगों में अनुभव की कमी होती है, जिसके कारण वो कठिनाइयों का मुकाबला कीवर के लिए जख्म दे सकती है। काफी छोटे 60 से 70 डिग्री में वो बिल्कुल ही काबिले तारीफ था। इस तरह के स्टंट्स आप बिल्कुल भी ट्राई न करें दोस्तों, क्योंकि इसे करने वाले लोग
एंड इट्स लाइक 215.5 MB, इट्स वेरी लेस एज वी हैव इनपुटेड, राइट? सो दिस इज इट. One more thing I need to show you, any notification will be given. So you can just go to the mail and you can get everything in the mail side, like the job having an error or this and that. Yeah. So that's it for the today's session. So I hope you like it. And if you have any queries, you just ping me on LinkedIn. So this is my LinkedIn URL. So you can ping me anytime you need any help and have any question. So thank you so much for checking out this session, guys. Hope you like it and see you soon, and bye bye.